It's the hottest day of the year. Is it the horse as well?
Entering an ice cave. Let's see how far we can get.
We are basically going to jump by ourselves without any instructors. So today's the summer solstice. Basically, people wake up early in the morning to meet with the sun. Some people just, you know, like stay awake until 2:30 when you had the sunrise on the 21st of June. We're now heading to the Lena River, and we're gonna have a little look at the sunrise like we did last time when the river was melting. Okay, so we'll see you there.
The summer solstice is a very important day in Yakut culture, sometimes even considered as the actual New Year celebration as opposed to the 1st of January. We were invited to welcome the sun and receive its energy as part of the tradition, despite the hordes of Arctic mosquitoes flying all around.
So it's now 2:31, so the sunrise has already started. It's probably somewhere behind the bush or behind, behind the clouds.
Bêtement, j'ai pensé que le moment où le soleil passe l'horizon, qui était le moment où du coup on accueillait le soleil. Sauf qu'en fait, non, c'est pas spécialement important. C'est surtout le moment où le soleil apparaît.
Okay, so it's now 3 a.m. We have been here for almost half an hour now. So now you can see that the sun is already pretty high. We got bitten by mosquitoes. Pierre like has all his face covered in like mosquito bites. But it was worth it. Summer is kind of nice, but because it's full of mosquitoes. I would say that probably winter might be even more pleasant. So now we're heading to Özkartın, which means like three birches. We're just gonna have a picnic, have some local food. Arrived at Özkartın. Oh, we're just gonna have a little picnic, sit down, relax, and have some traditional Yakutian food. And don't forget the burpakh and kumus, which is like fizzy horse milk with like a little bit of alcohol. Should avoid to drink too much of it because apparently you can have some troubles with your stomach. So we have some horse meat just here. Horse blood sausage. Han. Yeah, it's called han. What is this? Like intestines? Is it horse as well?
Yeah.
What else we have? What is this?
Cream? Salamat.
C'est grave chelou.
Allez, adieu. Allez, adieu.
Je vais foutre un coup à ça.
I found Michel.
Yeah, so just a little bit for goûter.
Horse milk, frozen fish.
So this is more. C'est super acide en fait, avec un petit arrière-goût amer.
What is?
You look like a food blogger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ça a rien à voir.
Rien à voir.
Alors t'es beaucoup plus sucré.
C'est plus facile à boire, je trouve.
C'est beaucoup plus facile à boire. On sent quasiment pas l'alcool. Enfin, je préfère carrément celui-là.
We then went around where Yakutia's biggest festival, Ihyar, takes place. Due to the pandemic, the festival was cancelled, which is a shame as this is one of the most impressive traditional festivals in the world, having cut some records such as largest mouth harp ensemble or the largest gathering of people wearing traditional national clothing. Every year, the festival draws about 200,000 people from all around the Republic. Which is a lot, considering the fact that there are only about 500,000 Yakuts.
This is called the Aluk Mas, or sacred tree, which is like a very important symbol of the Yakut culture. There's a lot of Aluk Mas all around the Republic of Yakutia, and we were very lucky to get close to it.
Just admiring the size of the site gave us a good insight on how huge the festival would have been, but I guess that would be yet another good reason for us to come back.
Oh là 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 là! Oh! Regarde le petit garçon!
Oh waouh!
C'est moi! Че, помолите я да гласа.
At the end of June, we joined a rafting tour along the Lena River. It was a really fun experience which took us deep into Yakutia's nature. And we've actually already made a video about it. So if you want to know why we had to put horse poop in our campfire, the link is in the description.
Today, we will go to Burus, which is about 3 hours from here. Here we are in Pokrovsk, which is about 80 kilometers from Yakutsk, a small town of 10,000 people.
On va prendre le ferry pour traverser du coup la Lena.
The Lena River, which is the longest river of Russia, divides Yakutia in two halves. Even though we are still very far from the estuary, the river is already more than 3 kilometers wide, which is a real problem as it isolates Yakutsk on the west bank from the rest of Russia, as all roads that lead to other major cities and the national railway system are on the other side of the river.
Currently crossing the Lena River, it's about a 20 minutes crossing to get to the other side, and from there we're gonna continue get to Bulus.
You can only cross in winter when the ice is thick enough, and in summer when it's completely melted. Which means that for about half of the year, as the ice is changing from one state to the other, there is no way to reach the other side except by plane.
Ça y est, on est arrivé à Bulus. Ça va être la surprise.
Ah ouais.
Et ben c'est impressionnant. On a eu quasiment 2 semaines de plus de 30 degrés constamment. Tout le mois de juin il a fait chaud. Et encore un gros truc de glace comme ça, c'est trop bien.
If you can't stand the summer heat, this is the perfect gateway.
So this is Bulus, and this place basically has ice all year round. It's very impressive because it's not just white, it's like kind of blue as well.
Bulus, which simply translates to glacier in Yakut, never completely melts, even when the temperatures reach 30 degrees or higher for several weeks. This is a great reminder of the extreme winter conditions, as even the harsh summer can't manage to get all the ice away.
Okay, so now we are entering an ice cave. It's kind of tight. Let's see how far we can get. It's pretty cold inside, and actually it's kind of melting, so it feels like it's raining right now.
Christian!
Vraiment, ça va super bon à la base. Il y a une autre petite ouverture.
C'est de la glace qui fond, du coup, c'est pas très très chaud.
Elle est grave fraîche.
Okay, so we got a little gift from Chukotka from a friend. He got sent some whale from Chukotka to Yakutsk. He kept like a little piece for us. I know it's kind of popular in Alaska, in Chukotka and in Greenland. So we were pretty lucky to get a little piece of that. So let's try. Whoa, it's really hot. Oh, it has a really strange taste. Yeah, not a big fan to be honest.
Je pense que c'est la première dernière fois de ma vie que je mange de la baleine.
I have the who.
Qu'est-ce que c'est que ce truc?
Est-ce que c'est un goût spécial? Parce qu'il y a écrit que c'est un goût unique apparemment.
C'est pas mauvais en vrai. Ça a pas le goût de poisson du tout. C'est hyper dur à mâcher. Le goût c'est peut-être plus du... J'en sais rien. Il fait chaud, on boit.
So there's one main beach in Yakutsk, which is where we are right now. It's pretty much in the city center. Today is the 13th of July, and it's currently 35 degrees. It's the hottest day of the year.
Le sable brûle. Non, je peux pas. Je peux pas. Je peux juste pas.
it's July, so it's like the public holidays in Russia, summer holidays in Russia. Yeah, we're gonna have a little swim, just cool off a little bit.
There's a lifeguard over there, people come with like tents.
Oh no!
J'ai cassé un saut de sable parce que j'étais trop concentré. The summer here is really short, in like 2 months it's gonna be cold again. Or at least cold enough for people not to go swimming. People enjoy the summer as much as they can. When we came here like at the end of winter, the ice was going all the way up there to the hills over here, and this was all flooded with ice.
During the whole season, we went to the beach as much as we could, as we knew summer in Yakutia is very short. As you can see, summer can get pretty hot, and in 2011, they even set a heat record temperature of 38.4. This, combined with the very dry climate of Yakutia, creates forest fires every summer, and you can smell the smoke all around the region. Then August came and we were just as busy, as Steven went hitchhiking across Yakutia to reach Magadan, which you can already find a video about. While I went visiting the Lenda Peters again, as it's completely different in summer. And we are actually working on that video, so it should be up pretty soon. But this is far, far from the last crazy thing we did in August.
So it's 5 in the morning and we just basically decided to go skydiving today. We are basically going to jump by ourselves without any instructors, and this is actually our first time, so let's see how it goes.
Just waiting for the bus to get us to someplace like south of Yakutsk. The trip's gonna take about 2 hours.
Yes, you heard that right. If you thought skydiving for the first time was already an extreme enough experience, we got the opportunity as our first jump ever to jump by ourselves without any instructor. Sounds about right.
This is the day I die.
We just arrived, so this is where we're gonna jump from. Apparently we can jump from a helicopter. Jump from 900 meters above the ground.
We'll be here all morning. Take rounds of like three to four people jumping roughly at the same time.
Even though we had never ever jumped, we got a few hours of theory the day before, teaching us the process and maneuvers when jumping, what to do in case something goes wrong, as well as learning how to land properly. Knowing all of this, we were still far from staying relaxed.
Okay, so apparently I'm gonna jump first because I am the heaviest, which sucks.
Steven is throwing his fourth parachuting bag. That's what happens when you eat Yakutian food.
So we are gonna be the second group. Right now the first group is in the helicopter, so they're gonna do the jumps and then it's gonna be our turn. J'ai réussi. I did it. Whoa, that was really scary, to be honest. That was f***ing scary, man.
C'est un truc de ouf.
The jump was pretty impressive, actually. Especially the there was about like 5-6 seconds of free fall, and then about like I'd say a minute and a half with the parachute. The landing is actually kind of intense.
This was such an extreme and unique experience that I couldn't resist jumping a second time.
Champogas!
This is Yakutia.
Even though most people think about Yakutsk as a cold and small city with not much going on, there are plenty of activities to do in summer.
It was amazing.
Yakutsk is a city that has the greatest seasonal temperature differences on Earth at 102.8 degrees, with the highest recorded temperature of 38.4 and the lowest of minus 64.4. Now, it was time for us to enjoy the rest of summer before the temperatures suddenly drop and the city gets covered all in white again. But that's for another video. Tell us in the comments what your summer is like, and as always, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the next video. See you in the next one.
It's been snowing all night. We had our first snow yesterday. The landscape has completely changed.
Makes me feel like summer was just an illusion.